Hi there, I'm Daphne Walbridge from the First Year Principal, and welcome to this week's coaching. If you're new to my community, I help first year and or aspiring principals thrive as conscious educational leaders. So today I'm doing part two of the two-part series on productivity. So just to catch you up, if you haven't seen last week's video, it was about, I presented two concepts. The three D's, if you're going to do yourself, you're going to delegate, or you're going to ditch. So that was one concept. And the other one was planning to plan, though. So finding time in your calendar to either maybe Friday afternoons to plan for the upcoming week, or maybe Sunday mornings. And I went into detail with this, so you can catch the recap of or the full lesson in last week's video. So this week, I want to talk about something that is very near and dear to my heart, and it is called the morning power hour. And this really fits in well when we are talking about productivity and mindfulness and being focused and present as a school leader. Because as you undoubtedly know, being a school leader, your time, your schedule, your calendar is quickly hijacked by other people's demands and other people's needs. And if you do not take some time, if you don't set up boundaries within your calendar, in your day, to calm your mind, to set the intention for your day, and to regroup, to center yourself, you are going to be leading out of reaction all the time. You're going to be reactive. And you risk burning out because the demands on a principal are huge. And especially during a time of pandemic, which as I'm recording this video, we are going through, I notice many of my principals, you know, extremely tired because they're on the front lines being asked hundreds of questions a day and having to respond. So the morning power hour or your morning routine is kind of a gift to yourself. And I often tell people when I talk about this, it's akin to paying yourself first. So, you know, the old saying, when you get a paycheck, you put 10% of your paycheck into a forced savings account. So, you know, you're always incrementally saving for the future. Well, the morning routine is just like that. If you spend maybe 30 minutes every morning of focus time to, and I can talk about what you can do during this power hour or this special time in the morning, when you mindfully set aside time for yourself in the morning, you are contributing every day, bit by bit, to your well-being. And this adds up like the peels of it, like the layers on an onion. It just keeps on adding and adding and adding, and it's building up your resiliency, and it's building up your emotional and spiritual health. And when you are spiritually and emotionally fit, obviously you can lead a school with more compassion, more presence, and more consciousness. So what does a routine look like? I've been doing this for over 10 years now. And this morning routine. And over the past 10 years, it has changed. Sometimes I would work on a special project, website, coaching videos, a book, or taking courses, professional development, meditation, journaling, visualization. You know, a lot of basically my routine in the morning, the first 30 minutes of quiet time at my desk centers around that. Today, I do more meditation and journaling. I'm focusing more on the spiritual side. Prior to that, I would focus more on the creative side, where I would maybe write a blog or outline a video or something like that. So it depends on what is driving you internally, what you feel you need most. But basically, that first part of the day should be focused on you and your inner growth. Of course, it's always best to not look at your phone, check your emails, because again, these are going to seep into your mind and other people's agendas are going to be hijacking your attention. So this is time where you should not have technology around you. And it's really a time to go inward. Another part of the morning routine, which is, I think, critical, is moving your body. So it could be vigorous exercise for 20 minutes or a walk, yoga, stretching, and of course, hydration, because we lose a lot of water during the night. So it doesn't have to be complicated. You can, you know, I'm giving you ingredients. You can cook with it what you wish. But a morning routine done every day is a gift to yourself, and it's signaling to yourself as a school leader that you are prioritizing your health, your wellness, so you can lead and be there for others, fully present, and you're filling your cup first thing in the morning. And when a leader does this, when a principal is able to fill his or her own cup, they are arriving to work present. They're coming whole as a person. They don't feel like they are being taken advantage of as much, because they know that they have given themselves the time and the space to center themselves before the day starts. And this is not only good for your work environment, but it's also good for your family, because they are going to feel the high vibrational frequency that you will be sending out, because you will have done the inner work during the morning. So that is the last little piece of advice that I would offer you when it comes to productivity and you know, taking care of your time, your energy. And the reason it's good for productivity, well, I think you can focus on projects in the morning. You can work on what's important to you. So that's being productive. And you're also creating the space to calm your mind, so you're not, again, reactive. And when you're not in reaction mode, you're able to make better decisions, more enlightened decisions. And you're not always busy cleaning up messes, which is also a big time saver. So that is the end of today's coaching video. I hope it's been of service to you. I would really love to know what your thoughts are regarding a morning routine. What do you do in your morning routine to start off your day on the right foot? And if you're looking for more coaching, I offer private coaching. You can check out my website, thefirstyearprincipal.com. There is a tab for private coaching. There's a lot of free resources out there. The Principalship Prep Checklist, the interview cheat sheet. There's all kinds of great things to help you launch yourself into the next phase of your career as a school leader. So I can't wait to connect with you and see what your morning routine looks like. Bye for now.